Hello, everyone. Okay, take number 5432. It's totally fine. Are you ready to learn today? Because I have prepared a Cinco de Mayo circle time. Are you ready? Okay, so today is May 5th, number five. We are on the 5th day of May, and it is Tuesday. Now, what letter does Tuesday start with? Do you know? Tuesday. Letter T. Let's do T in sign language. Can you put all five fingers, put three down like you have an L left, and then put your thumb up here and put this one down. Three, thumb, one. Oh, good job. T. Tuesday. Fantastic. So today is also a holiday. I don't know if your parents have mentioned it yet, but it's a holiday that started in Mexico. And it is called Cinco de Mayo. Wow. Yes, like I said earlier, good job remembering. Okay, so what we're going to do first is we're going to read a book about a Spanish artist. Now, this one has a twist on it because they turned this artist into a cat to explain to little kids. This is Hazel's book, okay? So she's little. This kind of helps explain. But her name is Frida Kahlo. And you might know Frida from Coco, the movie. Yeah. All right. So this one, though, is called Frida Catlow. That's so silly. Okay. And it says wild bios. That's what they call all these, a biography. So this kind of tells us about the life of her. Frida Kahlo was a talented artist born in Meowsico City, that means Mexico City, in 1907. That's over 100 years ago, so she is not alive anymore. She and her family lived in a house called La Casa Azul. La casa means house. Azul means blue. Do you remember? Blue. So blue house. So cool. Frida and her father, Guillermo, were very close. He taught her all about photography. She would even help him develop photographs. Wow. So photography is pictures. Yeah. And look closer. Sorry, I know it's a tinier book. When Frida was young, she got into a cool, awful accident. I think that means awful. She stayed home to heal and had a lot of time on her paws. So she spent it painting until her art was perfect. Wow, look at that. Frida's first paintings were portraits. She needed models, so she painted her sisters and her school friends. So she painted her sister and her school friends, and they modeled for her, which means they sat very still so she could paint. Frida was inspired by her Mexican heritage. She dressed in traditional clothing and often wore flowers in her fur. Oh, I love her flower headbands. They're beautiful. While she was in school, Frida met Dago Rivera, a famous Mexican artist. She showed him her art and they developed felines for each other. So they developed feelings. They liked each other. Dago Rivera and Frida Kahlo got married in 1928. Dago and Frida were painters for her entire nine lives. That means her entire life, they were painters. That is so cool. In 1939, Frida was invited to France, to show her portraits at a gallery. Paris's most famous museum, the Louvre, bought one of her paintings. It was the first work by a Meowskin. Mexican artist that they had ever purchased. This book is full of puns. Frida had a fervent love of animals. Look at all these animals. And often included them in her portraits. She had a pet deer, two spider monkeys, a parrot, and an eagle. Oh my goodness. One of Frida's famous works features a spider monkey. It is called Self Portrait with Monkey and hangs in the MoMA in New York City. New York City has one of her pictures. Wow. It's of her and her spider monkey. Wow, that is so cool. Frida Kahlo was often called a surrealist painter. However, Frida insisted that she only painted reality. Some of her most famous paintings include the Mew Fridas, excuse me, a few small catnips, and Doggo and I. Wow, so she painted stuff that was around her. Frida Kahlo is one of the most famous female painters of all time. Although she didn't sell many portraits during her life, many of her paintings are now worth millions. Her paintings can be seen in museums from Whiskerton, D.C., Washington, to Miyazako, Mexico. Fans of her artwork can visit La Casa Azul and see where she grew up. Her colorful style will not be forgotten. Look at that. So you could actually go visit her home and see where she grew up. That is so cool. I love it. All right. So we learned about a Spanish artist. Fantastic. And now we're going to make an instrument. Yes, that's our craft today, an instrument. Are you ready? Okay, so to start, we need two spoons. Yes, you could use the white ones that you throw out after you eat, or if you have like these plastic ones, if you're using ones from your silverware drawer at home, make sure you ask mom or dad first. Okay, I don't want you getting into trouble. That's not what Miss Cassandra's about. All right, so you always ask permission first. All right, so you will also need a leftover Easter egg. Mine's two different colors. You'll need tape and you will need rice. Did you get that? All right. So, first things first, I have learned my egg's a little bit bigger, so it has holes, and most eggs do, but these holes are a little bit bigger. So, I actually have to take a little piece of tape and cover those holes. Or else rice spills out. And it's not fun. All right. So we're going to take that tape and we're going to cover those holes. All right. We've got that. Are your holes covered? Mine are. All right. Next things next, we're going to pour some rice. And you might want mom or dad's help. Maybe you pour it into your egg. You could use a funnel for this. Or you could clean up your mess. But you clean up your mess. Yes. All right, because Miss Cassandra just spilled rice everywhere. So I have a mess to clean up. All right, I have rice in my egg. Yes. Close that. Do you hear it? See? And if you don't have enough supplies, if you have a little brother or sister that really wants one because my Hazel loves these, you could actually just make them a special egg and you could do the spoon. Yeah? All right, so your egg is going to go between your spoons, between in the middle. And you're going to get, you might need mom or dad's help, a long piece of tape. And you're going to tape around the spoons and the egg. This is going to keep that egg in there. Now, if you see, my tape only went to here, it didn't go all the way back around. So, make sure you get another piece and you complete all the way around. That way, it doesn't fall out when you're playing your music. All right, and then you need one more for your handles. This helps keep your handles together so they're not slipping and sliding while you're trying to make beautiful music. And just like that, you have a maraca. Wow. If you have just an A, you could do just an A. Yes? Beautiful. All right. So, being Miss Cassandra, I have written you a little song, poem, interactive song poem, whatever we want to call it, that kind of tells us about Cinco de Mayo, what it's about, what people do now in Mexico with it. So I'm really excited, and you can play your maraca with me, but I'm also going to do the sign language for hooray, right? So we fives and they go above our head and we say hooray. All right, so you'll see me doing that during the song too. All right. So, are you ready? Okay. So, I'm going to start and I have some picture prompts. Today is the 5th of May. Hooray! That means it's a special day. Hooray! In Mexico, they celebrate. They look back at this important date. Today is the 5th of May. Hooray! Would you like to know why? Yeah? Okay. Well, they won a big battle against the French. This was just a start. It was not a cinch. That means it was not easy. It took a lot of hard work. Today is the 5th of May. Hooray! In Spanish, we say Cinco de Mayo. Olé! Cinco means five, and Mayo means May. Today is the 5th of May. Hooray! Oh, they wear beautiful colors. They dance all around. They have great big hats called sombreros. They're round. Whoops! Today is the 5th of May. Hooray! They have fun parties and music-filled parades. They eat lots of food. They run around and play. Yummy, yummy tacos. Will you have some today? Because it's the 5th of May. Hooray! Happy Cinco de Mayo. And it's Taco Tuesday. So you tell your parents, get out those tacos. Nom, 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 nom. Oh, what beautiful job, friends. All right. That was so much fun. Thanks for doing that with me. All right. So I have one more book, and this one is about family. All right. So we're switching from Cinco de Mayo back to our normal family routine. Yes? Okay. All right. So this book, again, I had to print it out. It is called My Family, Your Family. And this also ties in because families from Mexico, they might do different things than your family does, but we are all still families. All right. This is by Lisa Bullard and it's illustrated by Renee Calera. See that? My family, your family. I'm Michaela. Did you know that I have the best family ever? It's true. This is my mom and dad. This is our dog, Tootsie. We all really love ice cream, but we love each other even more. Did you notice mom's belly? She's going to have a baby soon. The doctor says it will be a brother. I'm worried that will change everything. Have some of you felt that when your moms had babies in their bellies? Yeah, it can be a little scary. This morning, mom and dad have a plan. They agree the baby will make our family different, but mom says that different can be great. So I'm spending time with other families. Dad tells me to find one great thing about each different family, like a treasure hunt. So that's cool. She gets to go have sleepovers with some families that are a little bit different, and she gets to see how different can also be awesome. Ugh. I'm at Mateo's house for breakfast. He lives with his mom and dad like me. But his family is bigger and noisier. Mateo's three sisters talk a lot. And everybody talks loudly so that Mateo's grandpa can hear. Yes. They call him abuelo. Abuelo is Spanish for grandpa. Wow. That is Spanish for grandfather. We just talked about that. My mom was right that different can be a good thing. Mateo's family is so fun. They always have someone to play with. Wow. That is so cool. Next, I take a walk to Miss Betsy and Miss Roberto. They live together across the street. I thought you had to have kids to be a family. But Mom says all you need to be a family is love. My ears are worn out after my loud breakfast, so Miss Betsy and Miss Roberto let me do the talking. Here's a great thing about their family. They really know how to make other people feel important. Looks like they took her out to look at birds, and they let her do the talking all about the birds. Wow. I eat lunch with Olivia and her dad. Olivia's parents are divorced. Olivia stays with her dad on weekends. Her mom lives in another part of town. I don't know much about divorce, but I can see that Olivia's dad loves her very much, and she tells me that her mom and stepdad and stepsister do too. Olivia's family is pretty awesome. She has two homes where she belongs. Well, that's a good way to look at it, isn't it? Wow, that is pretty awesome that there's a positive outlook on that. All right. After lunch, I visit Jake's family. His grandma and grandpa take care of him. Grandma helps us bake Jake's favorite cookies. Grandpa shows us how to build a shelf. Wow. Jake's grandparents have had a lot of years to learn cool stuff, so they're really good at teaching Jake new things. They built them all this cool stuff. Wow. And they teach him along the way. That is fantastic. Next, I visit Parker's family. He's adopted. Parker tells me his mother loved him, but she couldn't take care of him. And Parker's two dads knew he was meant to be their little boy. His two dads. How cool is that? Here's what's special about Parker's family. His dad works during the day. Then his papa works at night. So he always has a dad around to take care of him. How cool is that? Kind of like you guys feel awesome because you get to be home with mom or dad all the time right now too. When I get home, my family is bigger. Nope, the baby isn't here yet. Grandpa and Grammy came for dinner, and Nana and Uncle Monty flew in a plane to see us. Aunt Jean and my three cousins are here too. Aunt Jean's the only grown-up in their family, unless cats count. So I know what makes their family great. Everybody does their part to help out. Wow. All that family came to see them. I'm sleepy. Mom and Dad and Tootsie tuck me in. Mom says my baby brother can hear my voice from her belly. So I tell him all about the families I met today. I know different can be great. Having a brother will change our family, but we'll still love him more than ice cream. Do you love your family more than ice cream? You do? Oh my goodness, that is fantastic. All right, so along with that, I put out on Sunday this packet of papers that you and your parents can print. And today's is Tracing Tuesday. And can you see? You get to trace from one family member to the other. And you have to slowly, carefully focus, try your hardest to stay on that dotted line, and you will do phenomenal. All right, do you want to dance to a song before you leave? Yeah? Okay, you ready? Get your maracas out.
Oh, my aunt came back. Hotels are two. She brought with her a wooden shoe. Oh, my aunt came back from old Japan. She brought with her a waving fan. Oh, my aunt came back from old Algiers. She brought with her a pair of shears. She brought with her a hula hoop. Oh, my aunt came back.
Oh, my aunt came back
from county fair.
County fair.
She brought with her
a
Can you rock? You rock? Side to side? Front to back?
Oh, my ass came back. My ass came back from the city zoo. From the city zoo. He brought with her. He brought with her. I'm not like you.
I'm not like you, Abel.
I'm not like you. Yeah. She brought back a bagel, not like you.
Oh, yeah. Wow. So she brought a nut like you. That means you are a super goofy nut. Yeah, are you? I think you are. All right, guys. I have loved learning with you today, and I hope you have a fantastic Cinco de Mayo and Taco Tuesday. Bye, guys.